I managed to find some trout in Lahore and I'm very excited to share this recipe with you. I shall be baking this trout and serving it with a side dish of baby potatoes and some greens. So stay tuned for this very interesting but very easy recipe. Okay, so this is what trout looks like. This is rainbow trout. I've washed it very well. I told the fish guy to clean from inside but leave the head intact. And I'm just going to make some incisions and I shall show you what I do next. After you wash this very well, and by the way, I wash it with salt, I pat dried it so that it's completely free of moisture. So when it goes into the oven, it does not dilute the masalas that I'm about to add. I've made incisions on both sides of both fish. I'm preparing the seasoning. This is pink salt and I have some dried chives. You don't have to use this, but you have to use oregano, thyme, parsley, rosemary, or if you just have mixed Italian herbs. And I also have a little bit of red chili flakes there, and there's some garlic powder. And that's what it should look like. So there's about a teaspoon and a half of salt and half a teaspoon of garlic powder and a little more than quarter teaspoon of the rest of the dried herbs that I have used. I'm adding some lemon juice to this, and after that I'm going to add some olive oil for cooking. I'm not using extra virgin, I'm using regular cooking olive oil. If you don't have olive oil, you can use any oil. To be precise, that's the juice of 1.5 rather large lemon and 3 tablespoons of olive oil. And the two fish pieces that I'm using have approximately weighed about 600 grams, so about 300 grams of fish per piece. Okay, I'm mixing this well and now I'm going to season this. But before that, I have some spring onions which are going to go inside the flap of the fish. I'll just show you. Okay, so I've stuffed each fish with a little bit of parsley. Two slices halved of musami and one spring onion. Now either I'm going to use baker's twine and tie it up with a rope, or I'm just going to use toothpick. Okay, so this is what it should look like. If you have baker's twine, then you can use that so it doesn't open up. When I lay it onto a baking sheet, then it's going to be easier for me to show you. I've melted about 2 to 3 tablespoons of butter and I'm just going to glaze this foil which I've put on a baking tray. Okay, so I've laid it out. Alright, so here are some garlic cloves and I'm just going to stuff these incisions that I've made with garlic cloves, maybe 2 in 1. I flipped it around and did the same thing on the other side. And now I'm just going to baste this fish with the masala or the herbs and lemon that I have prepared. Now you guys can always add your favorite herb to this, or you can even add black pepper. You can actually skip the butter and just use olive oil, but the butter is going to add an element of nuttiness because I love the smell of burnt butter. I'm flipping it around and doing the same thing on the other side, making sure there's some that goes in. I've got some onions here, and we're just going to char a few onions and some garlic in any case. So this is what I'm doing. And right at the end, a little bit of olive oil so the onions don't burn. Just going to toss it around a little bit in this oil. Sorry, my camera is completely out of focus, but that's what happens when you refuse to use a stand. Okay, this goes into the oven with both top and bottom heat on, and I'm going to place this in a preheated oven at about 180, and I think I'm going to wait about 10 to 12 minutes before this is done because the size is small. This is just a regular salad that I'm making with beef and iceberg lettuce and romaine lettuce. This beef was just leftovers from the other night, so I've shredded that, added that to romaine or even just a simple iceberg lettuce, and I'm just going to make the dressing. My choice today of salad dressing is just olive oil, mustard, orange juice or lemon juice, salt, sugar or honey, and a few dried herbs. Okay, so that's that. This is ready. I've made some potatoes and I want to show you what the potatoes look like. Okay, so these are the baby potatoes I've made. I've posted this recipe before, but in a nutshell, I boiled the baby potatoes in salty water. Then I salted it in butter, garlic, rosemary, salt, and red chili flakes. And that's it. So for this recipe, you have to go back. Time to use this and turn the fish. It's going to be a little tough for me to film it and turn it, but I just wanted to show you that we are halfway through. I've turned the fish around and I've kind of dropped that one flat on its face. Okay, so this is getting ready faster than I anticipated, so I'm going to put it up to full and wait exactly another 5 minutes to serve this. The onions are translucent. 25 minutes and we are done. I'm just going to serve this right now. Okay, I've laid that onto a platter and there's such delicious juices in the pan. So I'm just going to take all of this and pour it over. Oh gosh, I'm really hungry now. If you're watching any of these stories now, you need to know that this has turned out to be one of the best kinds of fish that I've ever made. And trout also is a big factor in this fish turning out so amazing. You may try this with red snapper too. I'm going to do that next. But there's really something about trout, and for me, trout is the king of fish in Pakistan, and it's not always available. So when it is, I, you know, would love to grab it and bring it home and make this recipe again and again. So you guys must try this. And I'm so glad you were with me while I was making this recipe of trout. And if you guys have liked it, I would love some feedback, and also appreciate you sending me pictures once you make this dish. You can make this with other fish, but I suggest stick to trout. Thanks for watching.